Morning, my dear students. Now we are going to talk about term 3, unit 1, magnetism. What is the magnetism? Magnetism is a study of magnet. So, pardon, one more question. What is the magnetism? Magnetism is a study of magnet. Next point, discovery of magnets. Next topic, discovery of magnets. Listen, look the picture. First, magic stone of magnets. About 2500 years back, in a place named Magnesia in Greek. The Magnus was rearing his goats. Magnus was rearing his goats. What is this? His iron capped stick stuck on the rock and strode direct. His iron nailed boots also stuck on the rock. The entire village assembled there and wondered. No, some other Jesus might be there. Definitely, this is magical rock. This is the magnificent power of God. Look, people wondered about this incident. Each and everyone expressed their views. What might be the reason for the stick to get stuck on the rock? Yes, you are right. That is a magnetic rock. People found it attracting not only for the stick of magnets, but also for the materials made of iron. Listen, people found it attracting not only for the stick of magnets, but also for all the materials made of iron. The more rocks of these kinds were found worldwide. These magnetic rocks were named magnets. And the ore is called as magnesia. The magnetic rocks were named as magnets and ore is called as magnetite. After the name of the boy, Magnus. The name is also supposed to come after the name of the place, Magnesia, in which it was found. Name of the place, Magnesia. Name of the person, Magnus. Name of the material, magnet. Name of the ore, magnetite. Magnetite was the ore with attracting property found in that region. Magnetites are natural magnets that are called magnetic stone. Natural magnets do not have a definite shape. Since They are used for finding direction. They are also called leading stones or lodestones. Next topic, magnetic of different shapes. After the learning the method of changing the piece of iron into magnet, we have been making and using several kinds of magnets. Such man-made magnets are called artificial magnets. Same two mark question. Define artificial magnets. The method of change the piece of iron into magnet, we have been making and using several kinds of magnets. Such man-made magnets are called artificial magnets. Two types of magnets. First one, natural magnets, and another one, artificial magnets. Shapes: bar magnet, horseshoe magnet, a ring magnet, and needle magnet are generally used artificial magnets. And oval shape, disc shape, and cylindrical and magnets are used also available currently. Magnetic and non-magnetic materials. Substance which are attracted by magnet. Substance which are not attracted by magnet are called non-magnetic substance. Substance which are attracted by magnet are called magnetic substance. Iron, cobalt, nickel are magnetic substances. Substances which are not attracted by magnet are called non-magnetic substance. Paper, plastic are called non-magnetic substance. Magnetic poles. The parts of the magnet, those attract the largest amount of iron fillings are called as its poles. The attractive force of the magnets is very large near the two ends. These two ends are called its poles. For example, north, south. The two ends are called poles. The parts of the magnet to attract the largest amount of iron fillings are called as its poles. The attractive force of the magnet is larger near the two ends, this one and this one. This end, these two ends are called as poles. Finding direction with a magnet. Two finding direction. One north pole and another one south pole. This is roughly the north and south directions. The end of the magnet that points of the north and points to the north is called the north pole. This is magnet, this one, this is north, this one south. This is roughly the north-south directions. The end of the magnet that points to the north is called the north pole. The end that points to the south is called south pole. A freely suspended magnet always comes to rest in north-south directions. Magnetic compass. A compass is an instrument which is used to find direction. It is mostly used in ships and airplanes. As a rule, mountaineers also carry a compass with them so that they do not lose their way in unknown places. The magnetic compass is used to find directions, place ships, airplanes, etc. The compass has a magnetic needle that can rotate easily. The marked end of the needle is the north pole of the magnet. Property of magnet attracts and repels two similar, take two similar magnets. Listen, four different ways, south and north attraction, north south attraction, N, S, N, and S, S, north north repulsion, south south repulsion. Do magnets lose their properties when heated and when dropped and when hammered? When heated, when dropped, and when hammered. Storage of magnets. Improper storage can also cause magnets to lose their properties. To keep them safe, bar magnets should be kept in place with their unlike poles on the same side. They must be separated by a piece of wood, and two pieces of soft iron should be placed across their ends. For a horseshoe magnet, a single piece of soft iron can be used as a magnetic keeper across the poles. Usage of magnets in speakers, in small electric motors, in some door locks, bags, in some ties, in composers, in pencil boxes, stickers, phone covers, etc. Science today, Buller trains. We know that like poles of the magnet repel each other, keep two power magnets as shown in the figure. For example, north north repulsion, okay, south south repulsion. This process is called. How does the electromagnetic tank work? Electromagnetic magnets are used in electromagnetic tank. Electromagnets are magnetized only when current flows through them. When the direction of current is changed, the poles of the electromagnets are also changed. Like poles of the magnets which are attached at the bottom of the train and rail track repel each other. So the train is lifted from the track up to a height of 10 cm. We know that we can move any magnetic object with the force of attraction or repulsion properties of magnets. These trains also moves with the help of the magnets. Attract on the sides of track and the magnets fitted at the bottom sideway of the train. By controlling the current, we can control the magnets and movement of the train. As there are no moving parts, there is no friction, so the train can easily attain the speed of 300 km per hour. These trains are capable of running up to 600 km. How? They do not make any noise. They require less energy and they are eco-friendly. Even though many countries have taken effort to use these trains, such trains are used for public transport only in China, Japan, and South Korea. In India, the possibilities of introducing these trains are under consideration. Points to remember. First point, magnets are natural magnets. There are called magnetic stones. Main magnets are called artificial magnets. Substances which are attracted by magnets are called magnetic substances. Substances which are not attracted by magnet are called non-magnetic substances. A freely suspended magnet always comes to rest in north-south direction. The end of the magnet, the points to the north is called north pole. The end of the magnet, end of the point to the south is called south pole. A compass is an instrument which is used to find direction. Like poles, north-north and south-south repulsion, and unlike poles, north-south, south-north attraction. Magnets lost their properties in the are hitted or dropped from a height of hit with a hammer. Thank you, students. God bless you.